For the time interval between 0 and pi, a particle is moving along the curve shown, so that its position in time t is given of x of t, y of t, where x of t is not explicitly given and y of t is equal to 2 sine of t. It is known that dx dt is equal to e raised to the cosine of t, and at time t equals 0, the particle is at position 1, 0. Now, the first part of this question asks us to find the acceleration vector of the particle at time t equals 1. So in order to do that, we need the second derivative. You see, the position vector given by x of t and y of t, we can call that the function s of t, the position vector. Taking the derivative of the components of this vector will give us the velocity vector, v of t. Components are x prime and y prime. And to get to the acceleration vector, we will take the second derivative of x and y, respectively. And so, once we have the acceleration vector, we can plug in t equals 1. So differentiating x with respect to t to find the second derivative, since they've already given us the first derivative, we take the derivative of e to the cosine t power, and we'll use the chain rule here to differentiate. E to the cosine t times negative sine t, or negative sine t e to the cosine t. In order to find the derivative of y with respect to t, and then take its second derivative, y of t is equal to 2 sine of t. So differentiating a first time, we get y prime of t is equal to 2 cosine of t. Differentiating a second time, we get y double prime is equal to negative 2 sine of t. So now we have the components of our acceleration vector. Substituting the value of t equals 1, we'll get the first component to be negative sine of 1 e to the cosine of 1, and the second component is negative 2 sine of 1. We'll need to use our calculator to find the value of each of these. So the first component has a decimal value of approximately negative 1.444. The second component will calculate to be approximately negative 1.683. So that answers part A. Part B, over the interval from 0 to pi, find the first time at which the speed of the particle is 1.5. Now, the speed is the absolute value of the velocity. And the velocity has components of the first derivatives of x and y, respectively. So when we want to find the magnitude, or the absolute value of the velocity, we take the square root of the sum of the squared components of the velocity vector. Square root of x prime squared plus y prime squared. Now, setting the absolute value of the velocity equal to 1.5, we can use that equation to find the time at which, well, the first time at which the speed is equal to 1.5. All right, so 1.5 is equal to, and we have an expression for both x prime and y prime, so substituting those values into the square root value here, we'll use technology to evaluate when the first time this graph is going to be equal to 1.5, when this radical is equal to 1.5. And we're going to see that this is a value of t equals 1.254 approximately. Using Desmos, plugging in the square root of x prime squared plus y prime squared, and then plugging in 1.5, we can see their points of intersection. Here, at the first point of intersection here, from 0 to pi, we see that the x value is 1.254. And in that graph, the x value actually represented our t value here, so we're good. C, find the slope of the tangent line to the path of the particle at time equals 1. Find the x-coordinate of the position of that particle at t equals 1. The slope of the tangent line would be dy dx, evaluated at t equals 1. Since our graph is in terms of x and y, the slope of our tangent line is dy dx, defined by dy by dt divided by dx by dt, evaluated at t equals 1. Using our expressions for y prime and x prime, plugging in the value of t equals 1, we get the value here to be approximately 0.630. So that's the slope of our tangent line. It's a positive slope. Next, the x-coordinate of the position of the particle at time equals t equals 1, we'll start with x of t is our x-coordinate, so that's what we're looking for, and we'll be looking for this when we evaluate it at t equals 1. Okay, so we can use the fundamental theorem of calculus to state that x of 1 minus x of 0 could be given by the integral from 0 to 1 of x prime t dt. Now, x of 0 is something that we already know from the problem that was given to us. And x prime of t is e to the cosine t. Since x of 0 is 1, we can then use this and rearrange it to state that x of 1 is equal to the integral from 0 to 1 of e to the cosine t dt plus 1. Now, because this integral has no elementary antiderivative, we will use technology to evaluate that integral. Now, I've already had substituted in here e to the cosine t in for y2, and so using my calculator here, I get a value of approximately here, after I add 1, is 3.34157. We'll round that to 3.342. All right, so there's part C taken care of. Part D, find the total distance traveled by the particle over the interval from 0 to pi. Now, total distance means that we have to take the integral from 0 to pi of the absolute value of the velocity. You see, the velocity can be both positive and negative, and we don't want to incorporate going back and forth. We just want the total distance traveled. Now, the magnitude of the velocity, again, is the square root of x prime squared plus y prime squared. So we'll put that in for our integrand. And I have that integrand stored in my calculator here, so we'll just use the calculator to evaluate this particular integral. And we get the value of the total distance traveled is approximately 6.035. If that were in meters or feet, we would add the units, but no units were included here. Well, that's it. I hope you liked this video. Please hit that like, subscribe, and notification bell for more videos, and stay tuned for the next one. I'm not going to be able to do that.